Balls.co.za.
It's my pleasure to have Dorothy Black on the line. Dorothy, can you hear me?
Hi, Hayley. Nice to talk to you.
Yes. So now I know you are on with Ian and Sasha and Daisy on a Wednesday, but I wanted to steal you for a few moments today because we need your expert opinion on Tinder.
Tinder.
I mean, have you been speaking a lot about Tinder?
You know what? I've had a lot of friends speak to me about Tinder, but I haven't spoken terribly much about it. And I think I was on Tinder for all of 20 minutes.
Oh.
I went on for 20 minutes, swiped, and then deleted.
So not a fan then?
I'm not a huge fan. I'm not a huge fan of the kind of catalog vibe of it. And I don't think, for myself anyway, I don't feel like I can kind of get enough information from whether someone's posted a good pic.
Sure.
And got a good one-liner. And also, I just, you know, it's just me. I just find it a little creepy to know exactly how far someone is.
Yeah, exactly how many kilometers or meters they are away from you.
It's just weird. It's just weird. But that's just me. You know, other people love that kind of thing.
So why do you think everyone's talking about Tinder? Why has Tinder beaten all the other dating sites and apps that are out there?
You know, I think Tinder fulfills like a different role. So you've got your online dating app or your online dating sites, which are obviously a lot more comprehensive and you can see more about the person. I think why Tinder was popular is that it kind of rolled on from the Hot or Not app. You know, where you're basically just like looking at people's profiles about whether you like them face to face. And then kind of added a little bit of more information that you would get with the dating websites. And so I think just the way it looks, the format, the easy swipe right, swipe left. I think that's kind of appealed to people's sense of immediacy. And in surveys, the developers have said that most people talk about it as being like an entertainment thing. You know, they sit, they've got a few minutes, they kind of swipe around, take a look at people.
They're not always looking for love. It's really just to keep themselves occupied.
Right. So I think that's the thing. Like it's kind of just like a fun, entertaining way to maybe see or meet someone who's going to be interesting. But I don't think there are that many people who kind of really place their huge bets on finding the one on Tinder.
Ooh, I know a few people.
Oh, really? I heard the term Tinderella the other day.
Sorry, what?
Tinderella. That's like a Cinderella.
So that's your love that you find on Tinder is a Tinderella.
Right.
I love that. So, I mean, I was going to ask you if you think it's a positive thing. You said clearly it's not for you, but do you think for people who are kind of not in the dating game or are looking for someone, do you think it's a viable option for them?
Well, you see, I think it kind of straddles the thing because so a lot of people say that it's a hookup app.
Yeah.
So you just go on there to like meet people to have sex with. But that only makes less than 20% of the people who actually use Tinder say that that's what they use it for. And then the other crowd is like the people who are actually looking for relationships are so far on the other side. And in between is just this vast kind of morass of people who are just looking to have fun. And so I don't know if it actually... if it's really fulfilling what it's meant to be doing, but I'm not really sure what it's meant to be doing. If it's just meant to be a fun game app, if it's really meant to hook up people, because it's not really hooking up people for sex. And if it's meant to be a big relationship thing, then I don't know if it's really doing that either.
I do know two people that are currently in serious relationships from people they've met on Tinder. So
on Tinder.
Maybe they, you know,
listen,
in the minority.
I think the plus side of that, and it's also because I don't use my personal Facebook thing. I don't really involve in a lot of things. And I think what people like about Tinder is that you can immediately see whether you can trust someone or not because it pulls in the whole mutual friends, mutual interests.
Which kind of keeps it safer than, you know.
Right. And so I think people, that's a huge plus. You know, that's a really, really big plus. On the other hand, to me, it just kind of, that's a bit stalkerish. Like I haven't met you and I immediately know like who you know. It's weird, but I think that provides like a nice safety net for a lot of people.
Okay, so you quite skeptical, but for those that aren't that skeptical, that kind of that want to give it a try.
Right. Listen, it's a fun thing to definitely give a try. Like, I don't know one person who hasn't loaded it on their app at least to take a look at what's going on.
Sure.
So definitely, and it'll find a home with people who are really comfortable with that. But a friend of mine said Tinder is only really good for people who look good and who take amazing selfies.
No, it is superficial. You literally swipe and going yay or nay based on a photo.
You're literally just going like, would I see you? And would I see you in a bar and I would think you're attractive? I think maybe I was just kind of going like, I know how unphotogenic I can be in photos and I would hate to think that I'm swiping the love of my life away because he had a bad photo.
Okay, so if you were to advise people as to what photos to put on their profile, I think they allowed 5 photos.
Well, the thing is, as far as I know, Tinder kind of pulls randomly from your Facebook page. And so some of the advice I've heard to guys is, because guys get this wrong, just make sure that you don't have, you know, albums of photos of you and your ex on Facebook.
Because
I think you can choose your profile pic, but for the other pics, Facebook just pulls them in. And so if you've got pictures of like you and your ex, or and your niece, but it could be your ex, or you and a kid, and now you've got kids, it could be your nephew, but now it's your kid. Ugh. I think you just need to be very certain about the pictures that are actually on your Facebook, and also what you've ticked on your Facebook as being interests. So if they're not really interests, then just tick them off, because Tinder's going to pull that in as
and
an interest.
People are going to judge you on that.
Right. And then think of a really kiff little little bio, because that bio does say something. It's only, what, 500 characters? But make it count, you know?
Okay, yeah. Don't just, give it some time and some thought and some creativity.
Right.
And in terms of, say, you get chatting to someone on Tinder and you both like each other, and you maybe now have moved from Tinder to WhatsApp, and you decide to go on that first date. What would your advice be for that first date? How should you present yourself?
I feel terrible, because I know that I am just super, super cautious. Like, the immediately going to WhatsApp before you've even dated someone. Do you know how many crazy people are out there? I think if you like someone on Tinder, like you would do on any dating site, you've made the connection, you've clearly established that you're both interesting, and then stop chatting, meet, go for coffee.
Yeah.
Go for coffee immediately before you hand out any more information. You have the front door house key, your WhatsApp, your bank details. Just meet the person for coffee and find out if there's any chemistry at all. Because at the end of the day, it is still just an online picture with a well-worded bio. And you're going to have to meet that person real quick to find out if it's something you actually want to pursue.
That's good advice, because some other people would say, no, talk to them, you know, make sure you get all the information before you meet them in real life. But I think your approach, makes sense.
Listen, as someone who's made a career on online writing and talking about sex and everything, and having people talk to me about sex and relationships, I promise you, you can make anything sound good if you have enough time to type it and to write it. You can sound like Prince Charming, the best princess in the world. It's amazing. And then you meet them, you've got nothing to say, they're a bag of sawdust. So get that out the way, just meet them.
Like that advice. Dorothy, I'm so glad we've made contact, and I'm certainly going to get you back on the show again when we've got other saucier topics to talk about. But we do need to end it there, but lovely to chat. Have a great weekend.
Cool,
and
thank
thanks for your opinion. So for the skeptics out there, I think Dorothy's on your side, but maybe it's something people should try and see. Give it a try and see what you think.
Ciao.
Okay, cheers, Dorothy. That's Dorothy Black, relationship and sex expert. So we'll get her back on the show again, but we just wanted her little opinion on Tinder there. I'm not such a skeptic. Dorothy's a skeptic, but I'm not. I know people who have met amazing guys through Tinder. But up to you. Balls.co.za.